were made to be courageous. We were made to lead the way. We could be the generation that finally breaks the chains. We were made to be courageous. We were made to be courageous.
Good morning. It's Pastor Larry here. It's May the 7th. And here's our devotions for the day. And we're in 1 Corinthians chapter 4 this morning. The Bible says this: Let a man so account of us as the ministers of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Moreover, it is required in stewards that a man be found faithful. But with me it is a very small thing that I should be judged of you or of man's judgment. Yea, I judge not mine own self, for I know nothing by myself. Yet am I not hereby justified? But he that judgeth me is the Lord. Therefore judge nothing before the time, until the Lord come, who both will bring to light the hidden things of darkness, and will make manifest the counsels of heart, and then shall every man have praise of God. You know, I find it both funny and frustrating that all it takes to be an authority today is a camera and the ability to clip and paste video footage. With a dash of ignorance and internet, voila, you are an authority. Trust me, I see the irony as I make this video. I do not believe myself an authority on anything except the best places to eat, maybe, and I honestly do strive to know God and His Word, but He is the authority. You know, you can spend an entire quarantine day filling yourself with all the world's knowledge about whether you want to call it a pandemic or a prankdemic. It's your choice. But there is another, and it's a better option. We can be, as the servants of Christ, the stewards of His glorious gospel, faithful. Faithful to walk and talk with our Savior daily. Faithful to take our burdens, our petitions, and supplications before the throne of grace. Faithful to use His word to evangelize and encourage others. Paul is used by God here to address something here that is vital. What will people think? That's what this judging is. People's opinions on my actions ought not to sway me from being a faithful servant of Christ. Paul says he doesn't even worry about what he thinks of himself. That's pretty deep. What matters is what God says, what God thinks, what God does, and what God is doing. So, and he says in verse 5, therefore, we need no opinion. We need no opinion. It doesn't matter what my opinion is, whether this is a pandemic or a prankdemic. For, you know, whether I believe what I believe, it doesn't matter. It doesn't change my responsibility to be the steward that God has left me here to be. I can be a good citizen and a good and faithful steward. I can do social distancing and be respectful of others and still be a good steward and do what God has called me and placed me here to do. So, don't be filled with fear. Fear of what may happen. Fear of what folks may think. Fear of, is this the end? When Christ comes, He will make us to know real truth. So, keep calm, stand fast, have faith. Now that's it for our devotional, but last night I made a video. We learned that Brother Richard Gore was in a car accident, and we didn't have a whole lot of information. Rachel, his granddaughter, who used to go to our church, has let us know this. He's stable, but has bleeding in his brain and is vomiting. He was on blood thinners, so this is not abnormal. And it honestly sounds like he is going to be okay, but the problem is he won't be released for a couple days, and he may have a spinal fracture. It's small, and they think that he could be released without a neck brace. Not sure yet. He is coherent, and they did another brain scan last night. We don't know the results of that yet. All I can say is please be in prayer for Brother Gore. Love you. Have a good day. God bless.